game of croquet is for the elderly will be mistaken. Take a look at these two. They are champions here in New Zealand, and I don't think either is over 20.
Dan, please welcome to the show Ruben Whyte, who is the chief executive of Croquet New Zealand.
I'm getting worried.
And this is Barbara Murray, who's on the executive as well, but is mainly a croquet player herself. And the men that are gently trying to hit us in the head with the croquet balls,
yes.
Phillip Drew and AJ Reid. Welcome to the show, guys.
Thank you very much.
Now, it's really exciting to see croquet again. I haven't seen it since my grandmother, I have to admit, taught me how to play in the backyard about 30 years ago. But how has the sport changed in New Zealand? I mean, obviously we've got young players coming up.
Yeah, we've got a number of young players coming up at the moment, and I think the game's been around in New Zealand for just over 100 or so years.
Wow.
So it used to be a start off like you probably did in the backyard, and then we've had a number of clubs reach the 100-year mark, so the further it goes on, the more young people we have coming through our ranks.
Barbara, what do you think it is about the game that is attracting younger players now?
I think it's just the sheer excitement.
That is
great.
And just the competitive nature of it. Do you know what I mean? You just really just want to get on and play better each time.
I can see these boys are competitive. It's much quicker than I expected.
How many people play in New Zealand?
To be exact, 3,748. With our world champs this year, we're looking to break the 4,000th member mark, which hasn't been done since the mid-90s.
Wow.
So membership's increasing.
So world champs in New Zealand
coming up.
How exciting.
Was that a score for you guys as well?
Yes, it is. Only the second time we've had the world champs in New Zealand, and we've got a number of young players. We've got 15 representatives at the moment in the world champs, so we're hoping to have at least a couple of them in the final eight. Hopefully one of them can take it out.
Well, don't we also have the highest-ranked woman player?
We do. We certainly do.
Jenny Williams.
That's amazing. And she's the number one in the world.
In the world?
That's incredible. Where is she based?
Christchurch. She's based in Canterbury. She's basically the world's number one, and she's just had a recent success at the World Champs Golf Croquet World Champs in Ireland, where she came third. And she'll be looking. She's the only woman representative at the World Champs for New Zealand, and she'll be carrying the flag for the woman.
He was saying there's two types of croquet now, and there's also another type that's quicker.
Yes, a golf croquet. It's just you've got a shortened version of the game where you can play I have a turn, you have a turn kind of thing, and a lot quicker, a lot more action packed. People seem to be really embracing that version of the game.
Sort of like one day cricket, isn't it?
Certainly is.
I think it might be time to bring these boys over before they knock out a camera lens.
Before they knock us out.
So boys come over.
Hello. So what attracted you to the sport?
Just it's quite a mental game, but you still got the physical aspect of needing control and power.
So this power thing I'm quite surprised with. How fast and how fast can the balls go?
Well, on a fast lawn, I've known to be able to hit the ball probably around 50k, up to 50, 70k.
Wow.
Some Egyptians are hitting about 70 to 80k.
Why do you, Egyptians, is Egypt quite a popular, is it a popular sport in Egypt?
Certainly is.
Yeah. It's quite competitive, isn't it? Because I remember back in the 80s when I was in Hamilton, I had a friend that played, and he called Bob Jackson Killer Jackson, and he was always trying to beat him. It's quite competitive, isn't it?
Definitely.
Now, we're going to have a turn in a minute, but I wonder if you could talk us through the game, basically the basic rules and what the goal is, perhaps.
You're aiming to get a pendulum swing between your legs,
mm-hmm.
so easiest way to hit the ball and most accurate. The goal is to get... You're playing with two balls,
mm-hmm.
getting around the 6 hoops twice for each ball.
And the least number of strokes, I presume, is it that one?
It's turn-based for the purest version of the game.
Right.
So you keep going until you make a mistake, and then your opponent gets to get going.
And what would be a mistake?
You don't make a hoop, you miss hitting your ball onto another ball, or there's a penalty hoop halfway around on the first turn.
Have you got
it? Because you hit the ball on the other ball, that's the whole thing. You don't just hit the ball willy-nilly.
Yeah.
It's not cricket.
It's a bit like snooker. The idea is to maintain a break. Say in snooker, you miss a pocket, that's the end of your turn. Just like croquet, you miss a roquet or you miss a hoop, that's your turn over.
Because can't people sometimes like play for hours? Because they just keep doing, they don't lose their turn. That must be frustrating, though.
No, when you play against these guys, the games are over pretty quickly, because once you let one of these guys in, you're history. Yeah, they'll go right round, hit the peg, and that's it, done.
Are you looking forward to the World Champs next year here?
Yeah, it'll be good competition, some really good people coming over for it.
And you're both in it?
Yep.
Fantastic. Well, do you think we should a bash?
Yeah.
All right.
Ready?
I'm going to put my notes down, so why don't you show us how to do it? Shall I go first, Steve?
Yeah, okay. You got a mallet?
No,
no,
no. Okay, lovely.
Fantastic.
A mallet, so that's good. So this is a mallet ball, and I have to hit one ball into another ball.
Yep.
So how do I hold it like this?
You can hold it two ways.
Yes.
And you're looking for whatever's comfortable for you.
So you can either do it like, oh, okay, I'm sort of
so you just want the pendulum swing.
Yeah. I think I like, oh, I think I like that way. So should I try and get it through that hole?
Yep. Okay. The idea is to follow through on a straight line, hard and through.
Okay. All right, here goes. I'll have a bash.
Oh, sorry, skip down.
Well, that was good. How does the steam have a
turn? Like a competitive nature comes out, doesn't it, apparently?
I won't just shout like you did and put you off, of course.
Oh, do we have accidents often happen?
Yeah, you have another turn.
Oh, I was aiming for the camera operator, of course.
One more turn for me and you, and then we'll call it a day.
So keep your head down and swing straight through.
Okay, hang on.
How long does it take to get good?
Oh, nearly. Close.
How long does it take to get good, though? Like, I mean, how long after you guys started playing were you, like, getting excellent at it?
It takes a lot of practice. I mean, as a young fellow, I used to be practicing every weekend, almost every day.
And now that you're an old fellow.
It takes good 3 years before you really start to perform at level.
That was better.
Well, we were close. And I'll tell you what it made me realise is how hard it is. Actually, it's not as easy as it looks. Thank you so much for coming in. It was wonderful to learn about such a refined sport.
And so if people over summer want to play, they can just go down to a croquet club and say, teach me.
Yep. We've got 120 clubs. So from Kaitaia to Bluff. Visit our website for the contact details.
That's wonderful. And they might even see a streaker, because they had a streaker last year.
Well, that's a reason to go, you bad girl.
Thank you for coming in today.
Thank you.
Now, Brendan. Thank you so much, Stephen. Now, if you've been admiring our garden furniture,